Are you tired of paying $25 a month just to send a couple of documents? Most e-sign tools are overkill for both freelancers and small businesses. You've got hidden limits, bloated features, and envelopes. What the heck is an envelope? Well, let me show you a simpler, smarter way to get documents signed. Now, without question, DocuSign is the most popular tool out there, but the problem is that it's not really meant for small businesses. Don't believe me? Take a look at some of their clients: Kroger, Remax, Domino's, United Airlines. Is your business even remotely the size or scope of these types of corporations? And further yet, their pricing is not only expensive, it's not even unlimited. Down here, you will see that they use a term called envelopes. What exactly is an envelope? Well, you can send more than one document within an envelope, but only one envelope is going to one customer. So you have to ask yourself, how often are you sending multiple agreements or contracts to the exact same client at the exact same time? So if you're an entrepreneur, essentially these envelopes do mean e-signatures. DocuSign's personal plan gives you only 5 contracts per month. That's not enough for most small businesses. But if you do choose to upgrade to Standard or Business Pro, you get a total of 100 envelopes per year. That's right, not 100 per month. That works out to an average of 8 envelopes or 8 signed agreements per month. That's why I want you to be aware of DigiSigner, a much, much simpler solution that actually offers truly unlimited documents. That's right. At just $12 per month, you can send as many contracts, NDAs, or proposals as you like. But more than just pricing, let's dive into the interface. You can tell just here by the left-hand menu, DigiSigner keeps things nice and simple, so you don't have to be bogged down by another piece of software. So let's go through a very quick example. Number one, let's upload a document. We can either do that here from our computer, or we can, of course, sync directly to our Drive or Dropbox account. I'm going to select upload a document, and I believe I've got something here. I've got a Word document that I want to be able to convert into something that I can send out to others. So here is my ABC coaching engagement agreement, and I've uploaded the document at this point. The very next step is for us to open things up and then start adding the places where we would like them to fill out pieces of information. And even if you've never done this before, it's really as simple as drag and drop. So to get started, I definitely want to add some text fields here under client information. So if I come to text field, it's as simple as dragging and pulling this over into these fields. So here you can see I can quickly and easily add 3 of those text fields. And as I select them, I can choose if I want them to be required or not. I can even give them a helpful name. So if I want to remind them, I mean, this is pretty straightforward, right? Name, email, phone. But maybe under the phone label, you'll notice that this can sometimes be helpful for users just so they sort of remember what we're expecting in there. I'm just going to put a collection of X's so that they know it's going to be a numeric field. That's not going to stay there. That's just giving them a reminder. So we've got a lot of ways in which we can quickly add those types of fields. And then if I scroll down to the very bottom, obviously we need a signature field for the client signature. And I can change this, right? I can drag and drop and make it a larger space if need be. There's no sense in them just adding the date field. Why don't we give them a date signed field, right? That's going to make a lot more sense because it's automatically going to put in today's date as a part of it. So now that we've populated those fields, we now have an agreement which we can send for signing. And this is almost one click. This opens up a new dialog here where I can simply enter in the name or the email address of the person that I want to send this document to. And just like DocuSign, you can can set a signing order or add multiple signers if you need to. So you can configure that all here within DocuSigner as well. I'm going to go ahead and hit send that document. And now I can easily see whom I've sent this agreement to. And I can also filter it here on the left-hand side. So waiting for others, I can see whom I'm waiting to receive that signature from, and also see a complete list of everything that I have signed and that has been completed. I think what I like most is that DigiSigner doesn't try to be everything. It's not cluttered with enterprise features that you will never touch. Yet, you can still manage your team here, and yes, you can create as many templates as you like. So, if you've been frustrated by limited free plans, envelope limits, or bloated dashboards, I'd recommend giving DigiSigner a try. You can use the link below to check it out for yourself. Start with their free plan or take a 14-day free trial of their pro plan with, yes, unlimited documents. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.